In this lecture, I will give you a brief overview of SQLite database handling in Android. In Android, there are several ways to store persistent data. SQLite is one way of storing app data. It is a very lightweight database that comes with Android OS. In Android, integrating SQLite is a tedious task, as it needs writing a lot of boilerplate code to store simple data. Saving data to a database is ideal for repeating or structured data, such as contact information. For managing all the operations related to the database, a helper class has been provided by Android and it is called SQLiteOpenHelper. It takes care of opening the database if it exists, creating it if it does not exist, and upgrading it as necessary. We need to create a class, let's say DatabaseHelper, that extends from SQLiteOpenHelper implementing onCreate and onUpgrade. This class performs CRUD operations, create, read, update, and delete on the database. Database names must be unique within an app, not across all the apps. Public void execSQL method belongs to SQLiteDatabase class. It executes a single SQL statement that is not a select or any other SQL statement that returns data. If the SQL string is invalid, throws SQL exception. Inside activity where you want to use database, create an object of database helper, which extends from SQLite open helper, and call the method getWritableDatabase on that database helper object. And this is going to give you an object of SQLite database. This SQLite database object is going to represent the database you have, and you are going to use that object to perform the different queries that you want to do. SQLite database class has methods to create, delete, execute SQL commands, and perform other common database management tasks. SQLite is efficient because it avoids the database creation overhead by creating the database only when someone tries to access it for the first time. By initializing database helper, we have not yet accessed the database. To access the database object that represents the physical database file stored on our device, call getWritableDatabase method on database helper object, and that will trigger the other lifecycle methods of SQLite OpenHelper.